My name is Andres Schirm. I'm 40 years old. I come from New Mexico, and I've seen some crazy things that I can't explain. There's something going on, just don't exactly know what. Throughout the years, I've had multiple sightings. There's a feeling you get, the hairs on your arms and your neck kind of stand up. You just feel like you're not supposed to be seeing it. It's not something that's supposed to be there. It's something unnatural. August 7th, 2023, at about 10:58 p.m., me and my girlfriend were traveling from Denver, Colorado, to Albuquerque, New Mexico. We had just come off the Raton Pass. We noticed it was a set of lights. And hanging half over the mountain, half over the highway, was it looked like just like a bright light at first.
Look at that thing.
I know, I see it.
Keep holding it there.
I am.
We started getting close enough to it to where I could see the shape of it finally. And it was your classic saucer.
What the f is that?
Yeah, it's a UFO.
It was low and it was big. It was about 50, 60 feet wide. You could see the light coming off the craft and it looked like asphalt. It was black and it was really sparkly and it wasn't smooth. This thing is like this to my left. It just took off, man, so fast. It blows my mind how fast this thing was.
Oh my God, can you believe that?
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden, off to the west, we see a light in the distance. And I'm like, I think that's it. Is that it?
Oh wow, babe, I got it.
You got it?
Yeah.
Is it back?
That is one.
Are you sure?
I've got it on my phone.
It's dimming and then it's getting brighter at a couple points. It's really bright. And then it starts ping pong, like disappearing and trailing off and ping ponging. And it was doing some really, really strange things. And then it eventually just blacked out. I don't know if it turned off the lights or if it zipped off again. It was strange. So all these things are really strange. There's nothing special about me. I'm just like a normal dude, you know what I mean? So why have I seen these things as opposed to, you know, other people haven't seen these things? I don't understand why. What's the point? Why put on a show? What are you doing? If I find out today that what I saw cannot be explained, that just adds to the overall mystery of my life.
My question to you is, what are you looking to gain from our exchange today?
I just wanted to see if I could gather any data, because some of this stuff is just so far out there. What are these things? What is their intent? And who's behind the wheel?
Yeah.
No matter what, no video footage or pictures is going to answer that. You know, we need hard data with a lot of this stuff. And unfortunately, that's not available to the public right now. I'd like to know I'm not crazy.
I appreciate your account because it's very vivid. You paid a lot of attention to your surroundings. You have stepped up with evidence. You want data, you want answers. Chrissy has studied this material and I want to hear from her on it.
I'm excited to see what you came up with.
You ready?
Yeah, let's do it.
So there's a few things I want to go through with you first.
Sure.
Can you give me the date and time of your sighting again?
So it was August 7th.
Yep.
About 10:33-ish p.m. at night.
Awesome. And now, you said there was a mountain. Can you tell me if you were east, west, north, or south? What direction were you facing when shooting the UAP?
So whenever we were shooting it, so we were going south.
Yep.
South on 25. The UAP was in two different areas, the actual footage, right? One was directly to the west.
Yep.
The other one was probably southwest, whenever you see the fencing on the side. That first one was probably southwest, and the other part of it was directly west, so looking straight out into the mesa.
Awesome. Okay.
Yeah.
Can you tell me the the shape of the UAP?
Sure.
You said it was saucer-like shaped?
Yeah, the initial sighting that was directly half over the mountain, half over the highway, that was the best way I could put it, a saucer. It was, went like, it was almost domed, I guess, but it wasn't like a full dome. It was really strange looking.
Yeah.
It went like that, and then it cut down like that, and it was completely flat on bottom. So it was like that, and then there was the lights that were going around, which illuminated the actual hole of the object, and that the skin of it, for lack of a better word, which was, like I said, like asphalt. Really sparkly, really super sparkly, and it wasn't smooth, which is what was strange, was that it wasn't smooth, because usually, you know, from what I know, they're usually pretty smooth, but this was real rough. Rough, real sparkly.
Andreas Schirm submitted a 2-minute-long video recorded on the Raton Pass in New Mexico on August 7th, 2023, at approximately 10:50 p.m. The clip shows a light off to the side of the road, moving erratically in the sky.
So the first thing we did was search flight data, satellite, ISS, and rocket launch dates, and cross-check them with date, time, and location of your sighting. So when we cross-checked date, time, and location, we did find flight data that showed two flights within view. But flying 31,000 feet above to the east. So that means it's not what you saw.
Right.
Referencing the video, analysts determined that the two planes, each flying above 30,000 feet, would have been located much higher in the sky than the object that Andreas captured.
And then we cross-referenced with multiple UFO databases and then see if there was any relatable sightings. We found that in 2021, a commercial air pilot did report seeing a long object flying over Raton, New Mexico.
Have any targets up here? We just had something go right over the top of us that, I hate to say this, looked like a long cylindrical object that almost looked like a cruise missile type of thing, moving really fast, that went right over the top of us.
Wow.
Right. So we're seeing that pilots are seeing the same thing, and they're correlating around the date and time, too.
Wow.
From your testimony, I realized I had to go to the five observables.
In 2021, Luis Elizondo, former director of ATIP, the Advanced Aerospace Threat Identification Program, described five unique characteristics of UFOs studied by the United States government. Anti-gravity with no visible propulsion, sudden and instantaneous acceleration, hyperspeed exceeding Mach 5, stealth capabilities, and trans-medium travel, the ability to travel through water, air, and outer space. These unusual properties have come to be known as the five observables and are often used as a guideline when examining video evidence of potential UFO sightings.
So watching the video and hearing your testimony, I see four out of the five observables.
Right.
Anti-gravity, sudden instantaneous acceleration.
Right.
Hypervelocity and cloaking. But the one thing that we couldn't do, it's very dark, so we couldn't stabilize your video. So it's inconclusive at this moment.
The way I come to my conclusion is by looking at a variety of factors, the nature of the data, the history of the area, the credibility and the aptitude of the witness, his or her penchant for detail. And based on everything that you've brought to the table, you witnessed a UFO.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
Well, so, I mean, that feels good to know, man.